Gender-based violence, of course, has increased during COVID-19. And the cause of the gender-based violence increasing is because people were confined in their homes. And where there were conflicts, where there were poverty because of not able to meet basic needs, then people tended to have some confrontation. And in more cases, there were more women who were exposed to gender-based violence than men. About 90% of all cases reported through 1195 were women, and about 10% were men who went through gender-based violence. I think I'm happy to report that with the opening of the schools and learning institutions, and also being able to give various groups, women, youth, some of affirmative funds to do business, life is going back to normal. So long as we continue practicing health measures, that is, wear your mask, sanitize, wash, and keep a social distance, I think everything is going to be okay. The cases are going a little bit down, and that means around 3 to 4% of the cases that are happening on a daily basis. That is not a license for us to relax on the measures. We should just continue with good measures. Asantins and Enterprise Fund to women groups, and today we have been able to give 24 million shillings to about 8 groups. The purpose of giving this affirmative fund is to support government projects. You know, government, through of course His Excellency the President, his vision is to see a united, peaceful, prosperous nation. People cannot be united if they are poor. People cannot be at peace if they are poor. And of course, prosperity is brought by people being able to have money to do business. Therefore, that's what we are doing here today. And in addition, we have been able to conclude that through the County Commissioner, Women Enterprise Fund, Maendeleo Wanawake, and other state and non-state actors need to work together for our development agenda, and especially making use of what the government has done in terms of improved roads, improved health services, education, and also we have been able to share a few of the COVID support government donation in terms of masks, girls kits, which includes also some sanitary pants, and the other materials that support people during this time of COVID. Life is coming back to normal, and that's why we are going around counties sharing and listening to Kenyans. What are their concerns? What has government done? And how we can serve them better? That's why we are here.